Yo, what's up? This is the second part of the reaction, so I highly recommend you to look up the first part if you haven't. Also, I know it's a long video. It took me a while to edit. I had a lot of footage, a lot of things to talk about. I guess. So yeah, anyway, you guys let me know if you like those long videos or if you'd rather have maybe just a ranking and something super short. So yeah, enjoy the second part. All right, so for Houdini, we don't have the lyrics there, so we'll go on Safari or whatever, and I'll find the lyrics, and we'll listen to it together. So let's do it.
I was listening to the album. Good fucking luck. You're on your own.
You're on your own. So this is the song where it was more kind of like a Without Me video, right? Guess who's back, guess who's back, guess yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's really that one. Back, I haven't even seen back, the music video or listened back, to that song. Yeah. Well, look for the stork run right. Little baby, okay, this is really Slim Shady vibe. Sticking out, yeah, like a sore thumb. With a forehead tint, it's you, I make believe. And you know I'm here to stay, cause me. If I was the ever, I gotta say, man, that shit is groovy.
Yo, this chorus is nice.
Slim Shady's back. Now back in the days of old me, my shit may not be age appropriate, but I will hit an 8-year-old in the face with a participation trophy. Cause I have zero doubts that this whole world's about to turn into some Girl Scouts. That censorship bureau's out. So when I started this verse, it did start off lighthearted at first, but it feels like I'm targeted. Mind boggled. He's really going at it. He's really going at it, you know. He's saying the old stuff he was saying, you know. He's not afraid to hit an 8-year-old in the face with a participation trophy, and like this whole world's about to turn into some Girl Scouts. You can understand what this line means, you know. He's saying stuff, and that censorship bureau's out to shut me down. So he knows in today's age or whatever what he's saying is really. It's on thin ice, you know. He's on thin ice, and you never know what could come your way. I mean, they're trying to cancel everybody from left to right. Also, I think it's that in that video that there's a lot of people, like famous people, that also appeared in the video. Makes you wonder if they agree with what he's saying. Oh man, you would not be down. You can't say that anymore. Things need to change in order to evolve. If we don't change anything, then we're not moving forward. We're not moving anywhere. So it's fine sometimes that stuff do change. You know what I mean? But again, I think he's all about a certain line. And then for him, we cross that line and now it's too much. We say that everything is gay. What's my name? Mike's happy. So how many little kids still wanna act like me? I'm a bigger prick than cacti B. And that's why these words sting just like I wonder how much he's famous with younger generation. Back my seat. Open R. Kelly's favorite group. The black guy peas. Peas in my Air Max 90s. White tees walking parental advisory. My transgender cat Siamese. Identifies as black but acts Chinese. Like I'm all for the I'm dead. I think I saw this line somewhere and I was fucking like, I was laughing so much. I was like, what is that? My transgender cat's Siamese identifies as black but acts Chinese. I was like, what did I just witness? Like, what is that? Oh man. Like, this guy is cracking me up sometimes, man. 90s, white tees, walking parental advisory. My transgender cat Siamese identifies as black, but that's Chinese. You should be a comedian, if not a rapper. Why? The whole world, cause I got it at my back. Why? But you can all suck my dick, in fact. Fuck them, fuck Dre, fuck Jimmy, fuck me, fuck you. Fuck my own kids, the brats, fuck them. Damn, fuck yeah, everybody. You too, Paul, got two balls. Like, Abracadabra. Yo. This song might be, in terms of sound, might be my favorite one of the album, though, I gotta say.
Alright, now I'm about to show you something.
What? Right, now breaking news, and it turns on This Week in Music. Detroit rapper Eminem, in a stunning move, has released an
album
in which he is actually trying to cancel himself.
Trying to cancel himself.
Now at this hour, we've got protesters lining the streets downtown, where Kimberly Gill is standing by. KG.
Hi, Devin, we are outside Eminem's Mom Spaghetti, where, as you can see behind me, people are definitely
I wonder if we receive any backlash from this album.
They're actually calling to boycott the rapper for songs that include insensitive comments about little people, people with mental disabilities, transgender rights,
and the First Amendment. All right, Guilty Conscience number 2. I was excited about that one because I really like the original one.
We did it now.
I know, right? It's beautiful, ain't it?
Yeah, you happy now, bitch?
Yeah, I'm talking to Slim.
All right, you got what you wanted.
Yeah, what?
Let me go.
Never.
Why does it feel like I'm always being tortured? The bad apple spoils the whole orchard. Used to read comic books to learn more words. Because deep down I'm a
really
dork.
Weird sounds the in the back nerd, of that album.
Meaning nerd to the core. Till I'm cornered.
The meanwhile, obscene foul prick. I kick one freestyle by beating down a special needs child. And these people freak out.
I told you we get slaughtered for saying retarded.
For y'all that love South Park, I just love that line. Oh man, Timmer! Like, this is so great. One of the fucking best character too. And you know, you think about that too. Like, South Park, for example, they made fun of a lot of stuff, but they still showed respect, for example, for like Timmy. And yeah, man, I remember when he was a rock star and he had his own band. It was insane.
Well, okay, you want a fat shame,
oh, yeah,
bitch.
So it's
you
going
can
everywhere.
Play that game. What? You want to judge people.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, ain't you the same one who hated bullies calling you bad names?
Ah,
then
see?
You turn around and did the exact same.
See, that's what I was saying earlier. Is he the guy that got bullied that now is turning around and then bullying people?
Anyone who hated bullies calling you bad names,
yep.
Then you turn around and did the exact same.
So
just immature and literally you're still mentally 13 and so thirsty for some controversy. You're still picking on Christopher Reeves.
Yeah, but you're me and we're a
yo, you know what I like about this one? I'm stopping a lot, but what I like is that everything that I said as we were listening to the album, I feel like he's addressing now. I think he knows when people listen to the album, what they were gonna think and what they were gonna say, you know, and he's addressing everything I said before, you know, the bully, bullied guy turning into the bully, talking about Christopher Reeves again, you know, just wanting controversy, stuff like this. So he's addressing that, and to me, it's kind of like it's crazy.
Oh, hilarity!
Come on,
nah, do your thing, fuck death people.
Yeah, well, between me and you, I think they've had it. I'm here with me too.
What the fuck?
Sorry,
whoa.
I'm not perfect as you, Marsh.
I'm dead. I can't believe you just did that. I'm fucking dead. Oh my god.
Yeah, well, between me and you, I think they've had it. I'm here with me too.
But yo, that is something too. You know, like comedians, in my opinion, are also under this, not this attack, but under everything that is happening in terms of like wokeness. So you cannot have a comedian nowadays imitating, for example, if he's white, he cannot imitate other cultures. You know, that is not acceptable. Back in the days, they used to do that. You cannot, there's a lot of things you cannot imitate and you cannot do anymore because it's, I'm forgetting the words, but it's just not okay to do so. So him doing that as well is just taking it a notch higher, even more offensive for people.
You said you had my back, liar,
but I helped to get your stacks higher.
Yeah.
That's diamond sales, like sapphires, rat buyers, admirers, peck lines of admirers. Now they say you lack ire, that's why you're set.
It reminds me, man, what was that song? I have Rain Man in my head, but it's not Rain Man, it's another one with like the chainsaw in the back. Please, yo, let me know in the comment section down below. But it really reminds me of that when he was talking to the devil, you know, who was like taking possession of him or whatever, and he was like, yo, you're nothing without me. So I really appreciate this conversation between him and Slim Shady. You know, there's like something battling itself inside of him, and I really like that. It's really nice.
Fires, rat buyers, admirers, peck lines of admirers. Now they say you lack ire, that's why your satire backfires.
Yeah.
Flat tires, no longer that guy you were prior to this. Yeah, and I scare you, cuz I'm who you used to be.
Who?
The you who didn't crumble under the scrutiny.
What?
When it was you and me.
Yeah,
I gave
see,
you power
again,
to
coming
use me
together.
As an excuse to be evil. You was a loner or nobody, cuz of me you didn't take shit from nobody. Now look at you.
What?
Now you're just a punk.
Yeah, that's again, coming back to the first song, I believe, or the second one, you know, when he started to not give a shit, that's when he started to make money. And it's really that. I feel like in his life, there was a switch that was made. You know, he was like alone or whatever. And he was like, you know, I'm done with that. I'm done with that shit. And then, bam, switch his whole mentality and perspective on things and then became what he is today. And now I think he's looking back at it and not regretting, you know, but like he's just looking back at it. Also, I feel like this album at where we are right now is a little bit of everything from a Slim Shady and Eminem that we received.
Addition to him, Will Smith in the cannabis. If you're listening, this is the end.
Okay, I'll
so
stop.
To Jamar and Ja Rule and to all my feuds, including Ma,
what?
I'm welcoming you to my
no.
last hurrah. I bid you goodbye.
Come on, man, don't
murder,
do this,
suicide, kill shot, booyakah, cocksucker, coup de grace, motherfucker.
Damn, he just killed him.
Whoa, what the fuck?
Oh, it was a nightmare? Man, I like that.
Come on,
where
come on.
Are they gonna take us right now?
Paul, you're not gonna fucking believe this, bro.
It was a dream.
It was fucking crazy. It was like the old me came back on the new me and took over my brain and had me saying all this fucked up shit about little people and Caitlyn Jenner and PC police were chasing me and fucking Gen Z was trying to kill me and quadriplegics and Christopher Reeves, and I was saying all this fucked up shit and I couldn't stop saying it. And then I'd wake up and it was like I was still dreaming. Fuck you. Wait.
Bro.
Doing my
that
best
thing's crazy. Oh, yo, that is so interesting.
Not blow my cover. No, it's all just a test. But I can't pass up this hunger. There's still a hole in my chest. And I'm trying to strap it with numbers. All you hoes got your checks. But I'm a queen when I run up. Cross a king with my hunters. Shooting threes
you
in the
feel
abundance.
The rage, like,
geez, I can thug it. You points to me.
Shut the fuck up.
Annihilation's
it, no?
What we love. Steady hitting, getting dubs. Just wait till we get the guns out. 45 na kalibre.
Ooh, okay.
Kung ikaw na bahala sa dinami. Rami mong mali. Utak mo lang may tama. Sa kitid mo mag-isip pare.
Guys, let me know what language it is.
I'm the new kid that these fathers can't fool
with. I like the vibe,
my new
slips.
I tied it in how these boots fit. I got that new drip that drowns Titanic or cruise ships. Don't you dip and dabble too close. Just watch us from a distance.
A lot of
I don't
little,
fuck with all that glucose. You fall in
need assistance.
I could do the same,
album.
But who knows? I'd rather say good riddance. Jack the Ripper ripping paroles. Annihilate with persistence.
Ooh, yeah,
to
the two
say
voices.
Different, but by today, I'm
bitch, you wish you had a life like mine.
Yeah.
You just fantasize the shit you write. You guys like lying.
Yeah.
Everything you ever been through multiplied by 9.
What?
Ain't even half the shit I went through by the time I was 5. Like what?
So my talking about what he went through when
knife,
it was
right
younger.
In the abs,
yeah.
And all he was trying to do was get my tricycle back. Yeah, Mike, like a gang.
Yeah.
When I pull it, a
damn.
Bullet from out a barrel the size of a derringer flies. That's how I would characterize.
That thing, man. Like, we don't know what he's been through for real. And that thing is crazy. I want to go back 2 seconds. It was like, saw my uncle get stabbed, took a knife right in the abs. Just because he was trying to get the tricycle back.
Stab took a knife right in the abs,
yeah.
And all he was trying
people
to do
insane.
Was get my tricycle back. Yeah, feedy still, if you're having trouble reading will, make it simple, he's easy kill. Easy name to remember, cause his rap name is the same, it's like 10 minutes on stages for me.
Easy
meal, or should I say measly meal? Yeah, cause
easy,
it sure
yo,
as mine
lines,
used to feed
bars,
me.
Shit.
Sleeping pills to keep me sleepy still, it was creepy cause the Nietzsche could have been Akron, Ohio, with Jalen Walker, ain't caught this much flack in a while, since
feel
back
like
as a
cold.
Child, and all I did was say like one thing bad, then it spiraled, saw you cracking a smile, then relapsed in a mile, ways back in the vial. Guess there ain't no civilizing a savage, and I don't give a fuck if you hate me worse than East Track on Revival. Bitch, I'm back like a spinal.
Ooh,
getting cracked like Kairos.
People didn't like that album. People didn't like Revival. And to be honest with you guys, I've listened to every Eminem album, and Revival, I haven't listened to it once. Not once. I just never did. I don't know why it didn't attract me or whatever. Kamikaze, I did. But yeah, this Revival album, I don't know why, but I was not even curious to see what he put up. Temporary with Skylar Grey. They usually make a great combo together, these two. I really like them together.
The truth is, I think what scares me the most is not being able to say.
Yeah.
All the things
see,
I want
that's
to
the
say
thing too. Not being able. What scares me the most is not being able to say all the things. And if you think about the fact that, you know, back in the days when he was younger, he was not able to say anything because people would beat him up and stuff like that. I think for him, this right to be able to say whatever he wants to is important to him, you know?
I think what scares me the most is not being able to say all the things I want to say to you.
I don't think it's going to. Oh, it's
no
for Haley?
Here. So this song is for
it's
Haley.
For Haley.
But when that day comes,
all it takes
it's
is
really
a new
cute
day
though.
Sometimes to get me in a better state of mind.
Give me kiss, monster.
So we didn't have any soft rap.
Love
this
you.
Is like the first one, more
could
sentimental.
Fall asleep, I'd be lost in a dream, but right now.
I wonder how he's gonna enter the song. And I just have to
remember. Just wanna say, look after Elena, Stevie, and Uncle Nate. And sweetie, be strong. I know I was your rock, and I still am. Saying goodbye is just not ever easy. But why you crying? Just stop. Haley, baby, dry your eye. This is not forever.
Really interesting song. I wonder when he said he's saying goodbye. Is it Slim Shady? Is it him? Is it like, what is it? When is it?
Yeah. And you will get over me and move on. You can play me on repeat on a song. Haley, just hang on. It won't be too long. I need you to move on.
Is it
on.
For when he's gonna pass remember, away, maybe?
We'll get better, cause time heals and the winner.
Yeah. I like that one. It's really cool.
I got you on tape cussing.
Can you hear?
Yep. No, babe. No what?
No, I said no, babe.
Okay, no cussing, no cussing, no cussing.
I'm dead. I really wonder how he was as a dad, you know? It's really interesting because you see this persona out there in the world and everything that he's doing, and then you wonder how is he behind closed doors with his, family and with the people he's around, you know what I mean? Sometimes, in my opinion, also what people project outside is different than the inside, but we never know. Also, now we're talking about actors, we're talking about music artists. You never know. It could be like a whole persona thing. But anyway, it makes you wonder what he is with the people around him and his family and the close friends. So Habits was with White Gold, and now we have this one called Bad One with White Gold. So let's jump into it. Let's do it.
Yo, Dre. Yeah. I'm going to just lay back on this. Let me apologize in advance.
Let me apologize in advance.
Fuck it. Forgive me. All right. Fuck it. I don't mean to sound arrogant. Fuck it. But yeah, my head up in the sky again. But even that, my stacks are higher than
money pilot told starts. To me.
That's how much I earn, man. Like drawing breath from your diaphragm. I've achieved every aspiration that I have had. Got a diamond plaque, a two, a three, a four, but that don't change my...
This song, I feel, is more kind of like a flexing. Like he's gonna flex about what he has and whatever, and he has this attitude, you know. I got a bad one. It's just like, I don't care. I got a bad attitude, but look at everything I have.
Aspiration that I have had. Got a diamond plaque, a two, a three, a four, but that don't change my attitude. I got a bad one. She just gotta put up with my shit. I'm going platinum.
Yeah, going platinum, going diamond. I'm going diamond. I just
put Fidel up on the link. I got a 1 minute you're here, next minute you're gone. Don't sit there and scoff, little bitch. You can knock the shit about me being immature off. It isn't my fault. The liquor is off and twisting my thoughts. You said you're looking for miniature golf. Thought you said looking for miniature golf. Your mouth is a hole. That means my dick is in golf. Sick as a dog.
That line is crazy to me. I just like the way it sounds when he pronounces it. It just, you said you're looking for miniature golf. Thought you said looking for a man to jerk off. Your mouth is a hole. That means my dick is engulfed. Like, it's just, it sounds so nice.
Miniature golf. Thought you said looking for men to jerk off. Your mouth is a hole. That means my dick is engulfed. Sick as a dog with two cars. Biggie is gone and Tupac. And I'm still alive and you not the woo dog. So who died and made you God?
Anything I like all the back mood off.
Attitude I've always had one. My temper's like the bitch I just scooped up. I got a bad one. She just gotta put up.
So here, you know, something that I want to add is just when he says she just got to put up with my shit. Sometimes, you know, too, like it's a matter. Again, it's all about this whole album is about like crossing the line. And sometimes, you know, yes, it's about compromise. Like, I guess we talk about a relationship right now or whatever. But if we talk about any situation, it's about a compromise. It's like when he says she just got to put up with my shit. Sometimes, you know, if you have, you gotta have some self-respect and be kind of like, you know what, that's too much for me. Now you're just throwing bullshit at me. You're doing stupid stuff. You know, I'm not pulling up with that thing anymore. But sometimes too, people just jump on the trigger so fast, and it's about compromise, you know. And if you appreciate the person and you want to keep a relationship with that person, you just gotta compromise and pull up with some stuff that maybe usually you wouldn't. But still, at a certain degree, have some self-respect and don't let everybody step on you. So there's like a little line to cross there. She just gotta put up with my shit, I'm going platinum. You just gotta like, put up with my wrist. Man, people that do some fucked up shit and they're just like, oh yeah, I'm like that, or like they're super aggressive or like rude, and then they're just like, oh yeah, but you know, I'm just like that. Like, sometimes it's like, shut the fuck up, you know? That's why I also understand why people would feel that way towards Eminem. Because maybe sometimes they're like, yo, you're just saying stuff to say stuff, and you're just being rude or whatever. And now, you know, just like, shut up. So I understand. With my shit, I'm going platinum. You just gotta put up with my wrist, I'm going diamond. I just put Fidel up on the link, I'm going gold now. I love all my records, but she said I got a bad one. She just gotta put up with my shit, I'm going platinum. You just gotta put up with my wrist, I'm going diamond. I just put Fidel up on the link, I'm going gold now. I love all my records, but she said I got a bad one.
Corny white rappers, yeah. I'm not a fan of it.
They separate all the white rappers in one category.
This $1,000 in my hand is just like what Candace did when she turned her back on her own race, because I have abandoned it.
Damn, okay, shots fired here. I think he's not a fan of Candace. Oh, and I know there was also already a shot in another song that was like, oh, Candace, blah, blah, and he said some stuff about her. But now this is like straight up, you know, like, I'm not a fan of Candace when she turned her back on her own race. Damn.
And me offending, use nothing new. Nah, fuck it, it's nah. What I love to do. Yeah. This is subterfuge just to screw with you.
Since day one, this much is true. It
sounds
people.
Like something that Puff would do at a party with Aaron Hall, cause I just love to fuck with you. A liner blush, foundation kit. Cause it's you, I'm makeup set. Brain is dead, space cadet. Like when Ye forgets to take his meds.
Like so when naked man, or angry at a statement meds.
That I may have said, I just say, man, I didn't say that shit. Shady did, cause all I do is write the rhymes and then wait for that beat to play. Spit him sugar finger, make like a green beret. Like he would get a sub machine to spray with him.
Yeah, he's always been up with that persona, you know, like a statement that I may have said, I just say, man, I didn't say that shit, Shady did. So yeah, he used to use Shady as an alter ego and like to be able to say some stuff and blame it on that, you know what I mean? A lot of artists do have that persona. I think Nicki Minaj, Beyonce, they have that persona that when pups up, then decides to do bad things, like say bad things. And anyway, not to get into that, but there's that whole like a demon thing. You know, for example, there's like a demon coming and then like saying whatever and just offending people. But yeah, the conspiracy theories and all that kind of stuff, for real. But let me know in the comment section if you guys believe that, all that demon thing.
Shady did, cause all I do is write the rhymes and then wait for that beat to play. Spit him sugar finger, make like a green beret. Like he would get a sub machine to spray with him. I should go back to those sleeping aids, because I'm so stuck in my evil ways. Then I'm fucked either way. The people still seem to think that they want the old me till they get him.
Got yeah, him up in arms. Like, man, I'm stopping a lot, but like, the people still seem to think they want the old me until they get him. And that's the thing. I think we said that before, but like, you cannot please everybody. You know, so like people are going to be like, oh, yeah, bring back the old Shady, bring back the old Shady. And then the old Shady is there and they're like, ah, you know what? It's not like it was before. So you cannot please everybody, and people want something, but they don't even know what they want for real.
I gotta keep going Tyson on Kelly. What? I bodied him twice and already that little motherfucker's back throwing subs. Like what? Like a food fight at the deli. And that is why he got the attitude he got. Like Liza Minnelli, my male ego is the size of the belly.
I remember he changed like the whole career of Machine Gun Kelly. And I remember also seeing at one point there was a diagram saying when MGK was the most searched for, people search his name on Google and stuff, and it was when he had this beef with Eminem. So like Eminem really, you know, like pushed him into fame in some kind of way, because yeah, he had like a fan base and stuff like that, but this really put his name out. And then after that he decided to switch to some like pop rock kind of stuff. It was a funny time, man. I laughed my ass off when I saw that. Yeah, so I think now that I'm thinking about this song, it's really more kind of like I'm like that and deal with it. Oh, a bad record? A record could be a lot of things. It could be a record in terms of music. It could be like a record, like your past record. What you've done in the past and you did bad stuff, you know? Interesting line. Interesting line for sure. Kobe. Oh, yeah, with Big Sean, huh? Yeah, I think I'm gonna like that one. That one, I don't know. I like Big Sean's vibe. The low tone rap. More grounded. Ooh. Yo, the melody is nice.
Shit. Fuck. Shit. Boy. Huh. Tobey Maguire got bit by a spider, but see, me, it was a goat. If you want space, I hope you take your helmet off soon as you get up to Venus and choke. Even while sleeping, be thinking so woke. White Cartier's all I'm seeing is dope. My city laying, and I'm Obi-Wan, got a mission to pass. I just might be the hope. Tobey Maguire got bit by a spider, but see, me, it was a goat. If you want space, I hope you take your helmet off soon as you get up to Venus and choke.
I guess that is the course right there.
Even while sleeping, be thinking so woke. White Cartier's all I'm seeing is dope. My city laying, and I'm Obi-Wan, got a mission to pass. I just might be the hope. No, it's from rolling up ventures. I stopped at Valero, think I should quit smoking. Man, life is a gamble, and I'm playing slots. Pull it down, close my eyes, and I pray I win token.
It feels like rallying people together. Gonna
take a baby sip, still taste of this potent. 1-1, sitting around the stars, double R, finna race. Hit a rave like a spaceship is floating. All this drip thing, I'm below sea level. Cut your own wrist off with that weak best. Ride around with the iron giant.
I like all the different flows.
Watch Unk break a rock down the three pebbles.
Man, some synths in the back.
Grand slam. Four pockets full, fully switch, go wham wham. Pants cramp, pull it out, cut it to my hands cramp. Road DSM on the beach, not a sandstand. Boy.
Damn, is it gonna drop now?
Hey, don't need no promoter.
Are they all from Detroit? I don't think Sean and Eminem is. Fuck about you, I focus.
Fuck all the drugs you take, I'm taking over. I paid attention, don't need no payola. Can't take away from me, you just need to take cover. I could paint a picture like I made this.
It's like a going to war song. Like you're getting ready for it. I don't know what the fuck they told niggas. I put all of my
heart and my soul in it. Tobey Maguire got bit by a spider, but see, me, it was a goat. If you want space, I hope you take your helmet off soon as you get up to Venus and choke. Even while sleeping, be thinking so woke. White Cartier's all I'm seeing is dope. My city laying, and I'm Obi-Wan, got a mission to pass. I just might be the hope. Tobey Maguire got bit by a spider. Me,
must have
got bit by a goat. I used to dream as a kid I would grow to be one. I hope that I inspire hope for you to go get what you desire.
So, yo, okay. So, after seeing that line, I have a question for you guys, okay? Because he said, I used to dream as a kid I would grow to be one. I hope that inspire a hope. So, do you guys think that this is a mission he failed to do? Like, inspire hope? Or you actually think he inspired a hope in a lot of people? Or, like, a lot of people seem to think that he's just putting hate out, you know? And not forcing, but making people hate stuff and, like, complain and blah, blah, blah. So, do you guys, down in the comment section, let me know if you think that he actually inspired a lot of people.
This going by a pioneer who is one of the reasons why I am here. They tell me I should just let the shit go and slide. Melly Mel shouldn't get no reply. That man is a legend. Bitch, so am I.
Yeah. Bitch, so am
and
I.
And anyone else who thinks it'd be wise and easy as pie to beat me and tries can treat me just like poison. They can eat me and die. Middle finger stuck up, but I never
like
conceded.
When
have I ever retreated? You never seen it. Every dream that I ever dreamt, I exceeded. Team at my legacy. I definitely needed controversy. I always sat on. I need it. Treat it like a truck hit a head on. Me times can't count. Sometimes.
He says it, you know, cement my legacy. I definitely did controversy. I always fed on. I need it. So he knows that controversy is kind of like what, you know, brought him, what brought him there. Like it pushed him, you know, because people spoke about it. People were like outraged. They were like, oh my God, what is that? That shit is outrageous. What is this? You know, like this white boy first doing rap and then talking about some shit and like going after his mom, going after the government and like people and just. Yeah.
Middle finger stuck up, but I never conceded. Whenever I ever retreated, you never seen it. Every dream that I ever dreamt, I exceeded. Team at my legacy, I definitely needed controversy. I always fed on, I needed treat it like a truck hit a head on.
I think one thing also with him is that, like you said, he never conceded. Like he never went, you know what, my bad or whatever, and just put his tail between his legs and just like, you know, walked off or whatever. He always owned what he said and just. Really, I don't know. Yeah, he just owned what he said, and he always did, I think, and he always, yeah, he's just really, you know what, that's what I am, and if you don't like the way I am, then, you know, you can turn around and go some other way.
Half a bag of Viagra, I'm gonna reach around and grab ya.
Bro, I'm dead.
Bruh. Sometimes I wonder if my homie's gay. Wait. Where'd anybody go? They left me again.
Imagine recording that. It must be so weird and funny.
Daddy?
Get put in here when she gets.
Come eat!
No, I'm tired.
Just come eat.
Lean up in here a minute, I promise. Stop.
Well, wake up.
Shut the door.
Somebody save me.
Again, it's a more emotional song, I think.
Me from my- Another pill as I start the spiral. Message to my daughters, I don't even deserve the father title. Haley, I'm so sorry, I know I wasn't there for your first guitar recital. Didn't walk you down the aisle, missed the birth of your first child.
Damn,
your first podcast,
rough.
Looking down, sweetie, I'm so proud of how you turned.
Damn, I wonder why he missed all of those things, you know? I think when she got her diploma, he didn't go there. At least he went into a different room to look at it from a screen because he didn't want people to see that he was there. So they all turned their heads around and kind of like, oh, man, Eminem's here. And now the deal is about Eminem. So he wanted her to be the kind of like under the lights, you know? He didn't want to take the spotlight from her. So I wonder if it's the same thing for those.
Hold a hug, my little nephews. Stevie, I'm sorry I missed you. Grow up and I didn't get to be the dad I wanted to be to you. Things I wanted to see you do. This is my song from me to you.
Yeah,
sorry,
I guess he really feels bad for some stuff.
What the fuck you want me to do?
Somebody say.
What was that line?
But I'm just so defeated, God, what the fuck you want me to do?
Somebody say.
Yeah.
Me from myself.
Yeah, so I guess he's not proud of everything that he's done, and like all the times he wasn't there for his family and for people around him.
As they lower me in my coffin, I feel the tears all falling down on my cheek.
Damn.
I'm a long call. Baby, don't waste your time.
Kind of sad that they turned down his volume a little. I feel like fading out would have been nice, but now it's kind of like, you're losing the power of the voice. The album just finishes like that. I saw some people saying, though, that it would be interesting to listen, instead of listening, for example, from the song 1 to 19, to listen to it in a different order, and listen to it in reverse. So like 19, 18, 17, and listen to that. Maybe on my personal time, I'll do so. But I'm surprised that the album finishes on that note. Though you got to think about it, you know, the last line of the whole album. I'm so damaged beyond repair. Life has shattered my hopes and my dreams. Sometimes I wonder, for example, if this song is from the perspective of when he was younger back in the days, or he still feels that way. One interesting line too is, as they lower me in my coffin, I feel the tears all falling down on my cheeks. So, like, at this moment, he's dead. Is it Slim Shady that is dead? And now they're crying kind of like the death of Slim Shady, because he kind of, like, took over at a certain time in Marshall's life. So now killing him, it's all him, you know, being kind of like, you know, I'm sorry, I missed that, and I missed this, and I did that, and all that thing. But now it's just time to bury him. Thoughts about the album. I think it was definitely an interesting concept to have the death of Slim Shady. I just wonder if it's really over for Slim Shady, and the next time we hear from Eminem is going to be something really different, or he's actually going to bring him back. I feel like it's hard not to bring him back in some way, but you never know. Maybe you could do like a whole switch. Oh, it's going to change. And now it's just going to be Marshall Mathers, you know what I mean? Maybe it's going to be that. So in terms of like what he said, I said at first, you know, that this album was probably going to be filled with criticism and opinions, strong opinions maybe sometimes, you know. And this is what we got, you know. He went straight up at what he feels is not right, at people criticizing him as well. And not excusing himself, you know what I mean? So that's what he did. He went to visit a bunch of topics that are really interesting, or like really, it would be really nice to have discussions about. They're big topics that people discuss, you know? I was surprised to have those two more emotional songs, because I feel like in the last album, maybe we didn't get that. I don't know. I feel like Music to be Murdered By, there was maybe, it's the one with Skylar Grey, like Black Magic, but it's not really like emotional. It's not personal. I was surprised because I feel like it's been a while. Maybe a Revival was the last one. But I remember in the Marshall LP2, we had a song like that with Nate Headlights that was more personal. So anyway, those two songs kind of like they came from nowhere in my opinion. I was not ready for that. Really interesting. Yeah, I feel like it's, for example, that's why it's an interesting concept, because I felt like it was a bunch of different things from different era that Slim Shady was in, and that all the different albums that he released back in the days, it's kind of like he took a little bit of everything and then made that one, which I thought was really interesting. A lot of those beats, in my opinion as well, were different. They were not conventional beats. So what I mean is that they didn't have really like A B, and then the bridge structure, you know what I mean? There was different parts. It was not really conventional. It was kind of like an A, B, A, C, D, and it kept on changing. So it was really interesting beats. A lot, I feel like the sound of this album is a little darker. I mean, we're talking about the death of Slim Shady. We're talking about death. So that's what we kind of like expected, at least, you know, to have something more dark. When you have a song titled Evil, Lucifer, and Antichrist, then for sure it's going to be, you know, what you expect, to have something a little darker. All right, this took me a while, and I'm sorry if it doesn't make any sense, but I have a ranking after my first listen of that album. At the last spot, I'm gonna have Guess Who's Back, the skit, and then after that, I'm gonna have the All You Got skit. After that is gonna be the 12th song, so Breaking News skit. I gotta kind of like put the skit down there, you know what I mean? They're not really like songs. After that, Brand New Dance. This song is one of my least favorite of the album. I mean, in terms of like song, it's my least favorite. I don't know, it just gave me like the creeps. It was like a little weird. I didn't really like it, to be honest with you guys. After that, we go at the song Somebody Save Me. Emotional stuff. It depends what and I guess when. For the moment right now, it was not really my vibe. It was a good song, nice song, but Somebody Save Me, I don't know, the emotional thing just didn't really get me. After that, we are going to Temporary, which is also another emotional song, the one with Skylar Grey. I really appreciate that song. The only thing is that I don't think I would listen to it on my time. I'm trying to think about that in terms of like, if it pops in my phone, do I vibe to it or not? And I feel like this emotional song, Temporary, is really more, you got to choose your moment. And it's a really nice song, but I don't think I would put my music on shuffle and I'd be waiting for that song to pop, you know? After that, we're going to go to Head a Honcho. Number, it's the 14th track of the song. I don't know, at this point, man, this one just didn't really get me. After that, I put Guilty Conscience 2. So again, I really like that song. It's a really nice concept. I really like the discussion in terms of if it's interesting or not. This song is really, but I'm trying to think about it again in terms of what I want to listen to on my phone, and this one is more towards the lower side. And then I put Evil after before, you know what I mean. Evil comes in the ranking before the last one we just put. And then after that, I'm going to Trouble, the third song of the album. Let me listen to it again. What does it sound like? Yeah, Trouble was the skit, but I don't know. I just like it. It has a good vibe. Yeah, what he's saying is offensive and stuff, but it has a really nice vibe. And then I'm jumping to the first song of the album, and it's Renaissance, which is also kind of like a skit that I really like. I like the vibe as well. It was really building up with that song, and I really liked it. So Renaissance, and then after that, I'm going to Bad One with White Gold, and right beside that, guess what, I also put Habits with White Gold. They have similar vibes, so I put them at similar spots or right next to each other. And then I'm gonna put Toby with Big Sean and Baby Tron. Now, again, this song too, I really liked, but the thing is that it was just building, building, and building on forever. And I want something that I can enjoy, I don't know, I guess like faster. I really like the song as an intro song, for example. It was really nice. Or if I want to sit and listen to something, I'd probably listen to that one. But in terms of what I want to vibe to, there's some other songs that I would put higher up there. After that, we go to Lucifer, the seventh song of the album. And then I'm going to put Road Rage. I really like that one. It was really nice. And then we're hopping into the top three. So I'm going to put Fuel at number three, which I really like, man. The rap, the flow, it was incredible. It was, man, there was a vibe. It reminded me of Lucky You, of an album that was there before. I think Lucky You was in, we spoke about it earlier. It was in Kamikaze with Jonah Lucas, if I'm not mistaken. So, Fuel at number three. And then I have Antichrist at number two. I really like the vibe. And if I'm not mistaken, this one, yeah, is the one with Bizarre in it. And I just, man, it just brings me back to D12 era, whatever. I don't know how to pronounce it. I guess I'm confused now. But yeah, Antichrist at number two. And then the number one, I had to put Houdini just because it's the first song you released, man. And like, it brings back, I feel like it's a good introduction to that album, that kind of like we're bringing back Slim Shady. I really liked it, really energetic, a lot of good lines in it as well. I just really like the vibe, you know. It's, there's nothing else like this song in this album, in my opinion. This is, it differentiates itself from the rest of the album. So yeah, this is my ranking. If I missed a song, I forgot a song, man, let me know. I'll try to check when I edit, but I kind of did this on the fly. And I feel like also after listening to that album many times, my ranking might change. But at the moment, this is how I feel about the album. And I'm down to go cook something because I'm hungry. I've been filming for a bunch of hours now, and I'm hungry, and I'm going to be listening to that album. And that is a for sure. I want to thank you if you made it this far into the video. If you skip, go back and listen to the whole thing, and I'll thank you after. But yeah, anyway, a lot of controversial things in that album, but I hope you guys liked it. Let me know down in the comment section how you felt about the album. And if you want to talk about anything, go down in the comment section too, and we'll have a discussion. You know what I mean? But yeah, aside from that, thanks again. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video. Don't hesitate. Go follow me on Instagram, TikTok, all that fun stuff. And on that note, I'll see you next time.